Welcome to Easy Gluten Free. Today I'll be showing FaveHealthyRecipes.com how to do an easier, slow cooker version of baked pasta. It's so easy, in fact, that the penne I'm using in today's recipe doesn't even need to be cooked before it's loaded into the crock pot. This dish has all the flavor of a lasagna without all the fuss. And I've lightened it up with low-fat mozzarella and ricotta cheeses, so you might have enough extra calories to have some garlic bread with this. Alright, to make this simple meal you'll need 1 pound of penne pasta, I'm using a gluten-free variety, 4 cups of your favorite marinara sauce, plus extra to ladle over when serving, 15 ounces of part skim ricotta that you've stirred together with 1/2 cup of pecorino romano cheese, 1 egg, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1 tablespoon of minced parsley, and some salt and pepper to taste. You'll also need 6 ounces of low-fat mozzarella that you've grated. That's about 1.5 cups. And 1 cup of gluten-free chicken stock. Now those are the basic ingredients, but you could layer in countless options here to make this recipe more your own. Some of my favorite additions are crumbled and browned ground beef, or some sausage with the casings removed that you've sautéed until browned, or sautéed veggies like peppers, mushrooms, and onions. The possibilities are endless here, unless of course your kid happens to be throwing a fit about the additions, then you'll be making the basic version like me. And besides, it's the easiest to do, so it's not all bad. Now first you're going to want to spray the ceramic insert of your crock pot with nonstick spray. Then add 1/3 of the pasta with 1/3 of the sauce, and stir this layer until just combined. Then evenly distribute 1/2 of the ricotta mixture, and sprinkle on 1/3 of the mozzarella. Now repeat by layering 1/3 of the pasta, then 1/3 of the sauce, the remaining 1/2 of the ricotta mixture, and 1/3 of the mozzarella. The final layer is the remaining 1/3 of the pasta, with the remaining sauce and mozzarella sprinkled on top. Now pour the chicken stock over the top, cover it, and cook it on high for 1/2 an hour, then low for 2 to 3 hours or until the pasta is cooked. Mine was fully done in 3 hours. Then let it stand for at least 1/2 an hour, but 1 hour is even better. While the pasta cooked, I made some garlic bread by stirring together 4 tablespoons of softened butter and 2 tablespoons of olive oil with 2 microplaned garlic cloves, the zest of a lemon, some Italian seasoning, thyme, and Old Bay, salt and pepper. Then I spread the mixture over some crusty bread and a gluten-free roll. Now whenever you're mixing regular bread with the gluten-free variety, you'll want to make a separate section on the pan. You'll also want to both slice the gluten-free bread and spread it with the seasoned butter prior to working on the regular bread to avoid any cross-contamination. Then stick it under the broiler for 2 to 5 minutes or until it's as golden as you'd like. Now when the baked penne is done, scoop out a portion with a spoon or a spatula. Then top it off with additional sauce and cheese if you want, and serve it with the garlic bread. Now keep in mind that when my pasta was done, I let it sit in the crock pot for 45 minutes, so it was fairly easy to cut into large chunks with a spatula. But you can feel free to serve this any way you want. I really hope you'll give this easy dinner a try and throw in some variations to make it your own. And if you'd like to see the recipe in print, you could always visit my blog. And for additional recipes and tips to fit in with your healthy lifestyle, visit my friends at FaveHealthyRecipes.com. See you again soon!